It took nearly 30 years to fill this parcel of land with residential trash. But in barely 3 months, contractors will be reducing the pile by more than a third.
It's typical in one sense in that we're consolidating the footprint. This particular landfill is 26 acres in size, and we're going to reduce it down to a footprint of about 17 acres.
Heather Libby is a design and oversight consultant for the MPCA. She notes the project is unusual in its level of public interest.
When I pulled up today, I saw a guy in a van sitting out watching, and he had noted that he used to work here. It's got a lot of history.
This landfill began as a city dump in Hopkins in the 1950s. This was days before there were rules for such things.
It operated as a dump. They probably burned waste at times here as well. Up through about 1971, at that time, the MPCA was getting a handle on all of the open dumps and requiring them to either close or be permitted as a sanitary landfill. So this particular landfill did get permitted as a sanitary landfill in 1971, and it closed in 1980 after it had about 1.5 million cubic yards of waste in it altogether. What is atypical about this particular landfill is that there are so many residents located so close to the waste, in some cases within 50 feet of the waste.
The proximity to nearby residential properties is what made it the number one priority on the state's closed landfill priority list. There have been no gas vapor intrusions into nearby homes, but that possibility does exist. So the need for this project. Once the newly condensed, slightly taller pile is created, it will be overlaid with a cover that meets modern standards. It will also include an active gas extraction system.
It's like putting a vacuum cleaner hose into the waste, and it's sucking that gas out of the waste that way, and then it exhausts it into the flare where it can be burned.